All right. 20 seconds until tournament time. I'm getting everything finalized here. Getting ready to go into 10, it now.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
10 mini goat. He has won 9 and I've won 8. I'm from SLO. I think last time against this guy I played this. Literally. I'm gonna mess with him a little. He learned something since last time. What do you know about that? I can go there and still get that bishop. So he plays here. What do I have to do first? Play here. Then I can go here. If he plays here, that will not be accessible to me. I've got to try and remember my analysis here. The old 10 mini goat. I don't want to play that. I could play here and go after this pawn. I don't think 10 mini goats doing it, but there are people in this tournament that are watching my stream when I play them. They told me that last week. Two of them. I'm the only person on Little Rock Chess Team is here. He just took that square from me. Play here maybe and then here. Could play it like that. This dude gonna castle queenside? I can still go here, can't I? I can go there and win that piece. One, two, three, four, five moves to win that bishop. I mean, is it worth doing that? Why is somebody sending me messages during my game? Actually, this is where I usually get into time troubles doing stuff like that. I don't know. I mean, I can play there. I win that bishop. I think I'm gonna play here for the moment. Let's kind of do the slow development. Move I was wondering about. I play here. He captures. I play here. He captures. Yeah, it's still a good deal, I think, for me. He plays here. I take the rook, he plays here. And I have to play here. He's got a pawn on the seventh. I've got a rook and a bishop, and he still hasn't captured my knight. I think that's a good deal for me. He's gonna have to back that bishop up and give me that h pawn. Or alternative is play here. I don't know about that. That was the move I was wondering about. Captures, captures. Captures, captures, and then I play here. He may play this, and then I have to play the knight to here to guard the rook that's holding the pawn back. I think that will work. Wow. I didn't expect that. Captures, captures, captures. He plays here. To play something like that, maybe. He's the one with isolated pawns, not me. Whoa, he hung a rook? What's this guy doing? Well, I will take that. Maybe I don't understand what's going on. It's possible. Maybe. Excuse me. I think I'll be having your queen for breakfast now. I don't believe that he's playing on. All right. Does this piece need to go? Push here, I can trade here. I don't even lose my bishop. Right? I play here. Next move, I capture, capture, capture. Or I could do it this way. I think I want to do it this way. I don't even want him to get this piece. This shows you how messed up chess can get when you. Point in opening all this up. You know, when you play moves kind of automatically, opening moves. I kind of just want to play this. and then get my break in later. Just do this. I'm plus 10. I'm fine with it. Is this square? Let me go ahead. Nope, I don't want any pieces coming there. Be nice to get my king somewhere, I'll admit. Here and here, and I drive him off that diagonal. Go back to here for safety. Somebody's watching me. Take. Rook over. King to here, maybe. I think there he's going to take with the bishop with check. Right here, he plays here. I take. He takes, I play here. Does he have any checks at all? I don't think so. Here. He moves the knight. I take his bishop, rook check, and I trade out everything. I think I'm going to move here. I can always walk my king away. Play here to guard the bishop. I'll take that off. You can play here. I'll take here. Rook checks. And I trade all the pieces off on this square. Of course, I am plus 10. It should be a relatively easy win. This guy should resign and go back to the tournament. I'm not going to give him some cheap win here. I think it's time to take that bishop off. It's just a little too sneaky. Now, he can't go here. He can't go here. I want to bring my rook over before this situation gets out of hand. Here, 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 here. Didn't have any squares. I'll play here. thought, I'd love to get to a square where I could win that night. Start going there. I used to win all the games where I was low on time. Now I have some trouble with them. The longer we go, going to guard that pawn. Here. The longer we go, the easier the next round pairings, because games are finishing and starting and finishing and starting and all that. So our tournament points are going to be lower when we go back in the pool. A friend of mine told me about here, threatening that pawn. You can guard it there, you can guard it there. I can take this pawn with check. I think this is the move. If he goes to e4, I made him. Friend of mine told me about knight h5, which is really great. Okay, now I'll take that one. Is that the thing to do here? Because he's going to check me here. When I move away, he's going to play knight check here. Think about bringing this rook around. Play rook here. Play this rook here. Take. Check. Here. Knight checks is a bit of a problem. I think I want to check him here. Still come in here. I want this knight. I'm plus 14, dude. This game is getting ugly. I should have played a better move last move. I'm going to play here. I wonder why this plus 14 is in blue. What is all this stuff in blue? Oh, did I highlight it by accident? I could have waited a little longer. I'm going to end up playing Fayetteville again. I know it. Book of the week. Only 25 minutes till book of the week. Or something like that. Thereabouts. Yeah, a friend of mine told me about two. See, d4, knight f6, bishop f4, 2, knight h5. Worked out real well that game, and I think the last time I played it. Schliemann. No kidding. I wonder what he plays against bishop b5. I'm playing this again. I'm not going back into that until I have a chance to look at it. I can play pianissimo. Let's see. Nope, can't move knights like that. Play here, here, here. Don't want to go into all that. Not really. I just soon beat him positionally. We'll see if that happens, so. Some guy keeps observing me and then going away and observing me and going away, et cetera, et cetera. Here or here? I guess here. What I was saying in that last game is the dangers of like memorizing a line and expecting to play it every time without any trouble. Sometimes you run into trouble. Like you have to think on your own eventually. Just my little 2 cents worth. God did it again. They keep popping in and out. Well, he's coming here, and that is going to be a pin, and I don't like that pin. I'm going to do this and go here. Wow. He did not do what I thought he would do. Standoff. Guess he's going to play all the same moves I play. I'm 11-0 against this guy. Go here, there's no going back. I don't believe. Look what he did. That's funny. He's guarding this pawn with his king. Really want to play that move. So you can go there too. Sure, the right moves here at all. I've never seen an attack like this with these knights. I don't know if I'm doing the right thing or not. That. That simplifies things. Take, take, mate. I can take a pawn right now. Take, take, and I mate him. Take, here I come back and take that piece. Discover check even. This looks like the move to me. Resigned. Play one more, then we'll do Book of the Week. Where am I now? Number 9. Oh, I'd love to play Tony D. Look at this. Monty Python. Where am I? I got 4 tournament points. Look at these people. Monty Python Strategy, 1895, 11 points. Chessmaster somebody, 1886, 11 points. This guy, 10 points, 1765. Tony D, only 6 points. This guy was watching last round. He was watching my game. I am 5.5, 2.5 against him. Well, that's nice. I've won the last 2 games. H3? I didn't see that one in my Greenfield book. H3. H3? I'm trying to figure out a way to take advantage of that. May not be any way to take advantage of it. I just view it as a waste of time. Coming here and here. What's this guy up to? I know there's a good move here, and I know I'm not going to find it. that square for my knight. Let's hear you play here. This piece. This is the most hated move in all of tournament chess. I'm going to play it. Could play here and here. Put this piece back here. Play here, here, here. Push. Take, 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 take. I have to give up my dark squared bishop. If I play this guy here, I have got to get him into the game. I play here. Can't play there. If he plays here, I come to here and here. Does that get me anything? No. I'm going to go here. As bad as it looks. So you're just going to. Oh, I need to attack this thing at the head. I don't think I have a choice. Here, take, take. And before he can get pressure in the C file, push it again. Will that work? I think it will. Here, take, take. Next move here. If he plays here, play it anyway. No. You'd have to, first of all, check and put the knight back. I'm going to do this. This is amazing. I got to admit, this is really amazing. Guess he's really into pawn chains. Take, take. Good move here first. Let's do this. I gotta start moving more quickly. Yeah, dude, I want your bishop. Get over it. here, here, here. Massive trade out. It could work. Oh, wow. He saw my little threat and he's attacking my C pawn. Well, first of all, I'm taking that piece. I'd like to play here and make him defend it. This line will just drop something in right here. Here and break this open this way. It's actually what I'm kind of thinking about doing. This guy can go here and here. Forget this dude's name. Okay, he is hitting that pawn, which is a bit of a problem. I guess I'm going to have to do this temporarily. Think about coming back here. This guy go. Go there and there. You can push to there. This guy's gotta go. Yeah, that knight's got to go. Sorry, bro. That's the way it goes. I move more quickly. he going to play here? Gosh, he really might. I didn't think about that. Moving quickly. Yep, that's what he's gonna do. That happened to me once, Monty Python. I went to the refrigerator, my game started. I didn't realize it. I came back and I'd flagged. 10 seconds. Check, and what does that knight capture? With his discovered. Nothing. Correct the mundo. Okay, he's going to play for that. That means I am going to have to blow this thing open with this one. I don't think he can stop that. Right. You got this whole thing over here. Deep Geek is streaming. Push, capture, 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 over here, queen over. I will not be able to oppose him on the file, but he won't have any entry squares. Will he or won't he? He'll have that square for a rook. King goes up and out. I'm not so sure about that. Badly, I've misplayed this. I know I had a much greater advantage early on. Come back to here or here. Could do like him and pile up on the second row, second rank. If your phone goes to sleep in those 10 seconds, it starts forfeit count. Better come back to the A8 or A7. If he attacks me. I don't think I'm going to get what I want out of that move. It's like an interesting move. Running low on time. Running very, very low on time. This pawn right here is very weak. Go up here. Took too much time. Took too much time getting to this position. All right. I need a break after that. Book of the week coming right up. Normally, I do not do opening books. But this time, we are going to do another opening book. And the opening book this week is Beat the French Defense with Knight C3, A Complete Repertoire for White by Pentala Hare Krishna. Thinker's Press. I got this on the recommendation of a friend of mine. And here's the back cover. And this is maybe not the newest book. I got it on clearance at US Chess for $10. Published in 2021. So it is fairly new. Seems to me like a pretty good book. I'm just going to follow it and beat all those people out there that think they can beat me with the French defense. So this book is about 450 pages. Beat the French with Knight C3. That's all I play against the French, is three Knight C3. The chapter headings, odds and ends, like odd third moves. Knight C6, which I've encountered on here recently. The Rubinstein variation. What's the Rubinstein again? Good question. Knight F6, E5. And 5, Knight CE2. Huh? Knight F6, E5, F, and 5, F4. And the anti-Winauer Katalimov, I have to spend a little more time with this book, which is why I bought it. The Katalimov variation. I always had a dream of becoming a chess author. He starts off the preface. As my years of experience and analysis grew, it was becoming a more and more frequent topic of discussions with my loved ones and friends. GM Hare Krishna is an established elite player who has been in India's Olympiad team for over 2 decades. That's impressive. Since November 2016, he has often entered the top 10 of the world rankings and has consistently stayed in the top 20. His peak rating is 2770. He's well known for his exceptional in-game skills, as well as for the ability to convert positions with a slight or even no advantage. Looks like a chessable. He builds on the material from his earlier French course, Chessable, May 2019. Beating the French with 3 Knight C3. Book of the week this week. Check it out. You can get it at US Chess for $10. I've got time for one more game. That last one, I thought for sure I was going to lose that game. I sure did. It's like, this is it. Number 13. Oh, somebody else, DMS, HD Smasher, whatever, started playing the tournament. And I am playing this guy, 5657586. I guess I'll call him. Fox Valley Chess Club. Hey, I want to get you to try it out right here. Dude, did you read this book? Because if you didn't, you're in trouble. It's just right there, just inches away for me to look at and see what is my next move. Ah! I do this. Night. Isn't he? They always play that. I guess I should have read the book. Should have played Knight B5. Side's kind of wrapped up, isn't it? His rating's high enough, he probably knows what he's doing. I'm thinking about just castling. Come on, you know you want to do it. He wants to win it. Play here and trap your own bishop. I did that once. It's French defense. How embarrassing. Right after I talk about the book. Let me see. Okay, if I move here, he plays here, he traps my bishop. That's no good. Capture here, he can capture here and win this one later. How does he just sit in the middle of the board and do nothing? I'm going to lose a pawn. I'm thrilled about that. I might even lose two pawns the way this is going. Can't go here. I'll play here. Rather I take here. Problem is I play here, he's not going to take it. He's going to do something like queen here. Neither of those are any good. I'm going to go here. He's the one sitting dead center on the board. At least my pieces will be developed. What's stopping him from getting this guy? As I said, okay, if I take here attacking his queen, he could take here or here attacking mine. Then I take his queen, he takes my queen, I take his bishop. I'm down a piece right now, though. You want a pawn. I'm 4-0 against this guy. Now, if I capture here, I just won the pawn back, right? Is that true? Captures, and I capture his queen with my rook. He doesn't have a move. Play here, he plays here. I play here. No matter what, I keep my pawn. He did do that to me. It's going to be a little hard for him to develop. Knight here, push. Knight here attacks all of his pieces. Or you can do that. Uh-oh. That's going to create a problem. Isn't it? I don't know why I didn't see that. Simple tactics. just put another piece on this, didn't he? I can't defend all those pieces. Well, it was a great tournament, wasn't it? How do I get out of this mess? Is there getting out of this any getting out of this mess? Work either. Nothing will be done. Not that I can see. What are these mysterious people down here in the corner? Takes so long to recapture the queen. That's weird, isn't it? Look at this, what he just did to me. Okay, if I go over here, he's gonna, if I go here, he's gonna check me here. And then he's gonna win this pawn and this pawn and this pawn. That's why I think I may have to trade off my rook. He's still gonna get this one. Looking seriously bad for the home team. Well, it was fun while it lasted. Can't believe Queen H4, G5. What an idiot. I don't think I had a draw in that endgame. I think I was one move away from coming in. Good game. That is the end of that. Okay. So I finished 22nd in the tournament. And I blew my last game. All right. Well, that was fun. You can't win them all, I guess. Finished at 2053, 8 tournament points. Oh, Queen BD's on here. She's playing. I've played her 4 times. I didn't realize that. All right, Chess, we finished 8-2. 10 points. 7th place. Oh, well. That's the way it goes. That's it for another Monday night. I was feeling great right to the end. Have a good week. Goodbye.